Hey guys, this is David Kwan. So finally we have some good news from the United States government. Finally. I mean, seriously, the past couple of months, almost everything I read or watched in regards to American politics has just been really bad. Dismally bad. Terrifyingly bad. And for the most part, this country is, and this administration leading it, is still an unethical mess. But at least we have this recent victory, or these recent victories. The U.S. Supreme Court struck down California's Proposition 8 and a significant portion of DOMA. Those are struck down now. I mean, it's crazy that around the same time, the Supreme Court also struck down a significant portion of the Voting Rights Act, making this country regress back towards the Jim Crow era. And like I said before, this country is still a complete political mess. But damn it, at the very least, we have this victory. At the very least. It's such a long time coming, and when I look at the big picture, these are ultimately still very small victories, but nonetheless, I'm glad we have these victories. And these victories are by a hair. Really, by a hair. Four justices wanted to uphold Prop 8 and DOMA, and five justices ruled to strike down Prop 8 and DOMA. So it was just 5-4. It was Justice Anthony Kennedy, ultimately, who broke the tie. So, by a hair, by a fucking hair, we have these victories. And I think that's crazy. This means that the Supreme Court almost decided to support the stupid, bigoted legislation that is Prop 8 and DOMA. So, this country is a mess right now, but I would still have become even more, extremely more pissed off if Supreme Court, of course, made the stupid ruling in this case. And I'm glad they did not. What's really interesting to me is that Justice Kennedy ruled that DOMA was unconstitutional because it was in violation of the Fifth Amendment. The Fifth Amendment, not the Tenth Amendment. It makes great sense, but I definitely did not expect that. And overall, I think that's actually a really awesome thing. Because if Edith B. Windsor is ultimately about the Fifth Amendment and not about the Tenth Amendment, then what this means is that DOMA can be considered unconstitutional, but at the same time, ROMA, which is Respect the Marriage Act, once passed, can still be considered constitutional. And that's huge. And that's my hope anyway. I'm glad more and more states are starting to legalize gay marriage, but it ultimately really is still too slow of a process for me, and I'm too impatient for it. ROMA is what needs to be passed. What needs to happen is that gay marriage should be legally recognized by the entire country and not just by 13 states, and that's what ROMA would do. Not only that, ROMA needs to be passed because Edith B. Windsor is still not a big enough victory for us who are advocating for gay rights. Because this victory means that the federal government will only recognize as legal the gay marriages that are recognized in those 13 states. If, for example, a gay couple gets married in New York and then moves to live in Wyoming, the federal government no longer recognizes them as a legally married couple. Because gay marriage is legal in New York, but it's not legal in Wyoming. You move to Wyoming or any of the, you know, freaking 37 states that doesn't have gay marriage as a legally recognized thing, then you no longer are legally married anymore. In essence, this confines gay married families to 13 states if they wish to maintain their marriage benefits and their rights and their status as a married couple or family. So yeah, this status quo, even with Edith B. Windsor, for LGBT peoples is still incredibly, incredibly fucked up. I'm glad we had these two awesome victories recently, but this really shows that there's still so much left to change and to fight for.